National Housing Fund bill, if it becomes a law, people who earn minimum wage will pay 250% of what they'll pay in personal income tax by way of PAYE into this fund. So this is more than twice as damaging to their income. These are also people who are very unlikely to get any forms of loan from the NHF, because for you to get any loan from the NHF, they need to project your income and see your ability to repay the loan. If you earn 18,000, the Labour Act says the maximum we can deduct from your income monthly is 1/3. So which means, assuming you pay no other statutory payment, we take 6,000 from you, you have up to 30 years to pay back. It's not even up to 2 million naira. What can you build with 2 million naira? So the maximum you can even get is 2 million naira, even if you're lucky to access it. So the question is, if I'm unlikely to get a loan to build a home, why punish me if I'm already one of the most vulnerable people in Nigeria? So from a policy perspective, we need to take a step back and say the purpose of the NHM is not to make affordable finance available, it is to make affordable housing available. The fact that even the cost of borrowing is affordable does not mean that the ultimate delivery of the home will be affordable, right? So why don't we think about things that are not very conventional? How about pallet homes? How about outbuildings? How about containers? You know, we have different, unfortunately, you know, the cost of building a house in Nigeria is one of the most expensive in the world. The NBS, National Bureau of Statistics, conducted a survey in 2015 and found out that it would cost almost twice as much to build a house in Nigeria as it would in India, about 30% more than in South Africa. Unfortunately, which is also an irony, on the other hand, we're one of the poorest nations in the world. So, very expensive to build a home, poor people. How do you bridge the gap?